Have we heard anything, Yamiche, more from the White House doctor about any potential course of action beyond the stuff I'm talking about?
As of now, we haven't. The letter yesterday made clear that, the White House doctor will be continuing to monitor President Trump and the First Lady. But as you pointed out, he is 74. He is a senior. He is someone who evidence shows is overweight. And as a result, he is in that population of people that we've been talking about for months that are at higher risk for complications and more serious impacts from the virus. There's no evidence that he is seeing or experiencing any conflicts or any particular serious symptoms as of right now. But I want to reiterate that we're talking about a senior citizen and someone who falls in the group of people that Dr. Fauci and so many other health officials have said have to be extra vigilant when it comes to this virus. Another thing to note is that he is an American who is one of the most protected, if not the most protected American in the country. And as a result, it really underscores that anyone can get this virus. If the president of the United States, who people around him are tested daily, who is constantly surrounded by people, medical officials to take care of him. If he can get this virus and then have to deal with the symptoms and have to quarantine, it just underscores how much this is really getting into American society. So I think the president, of course, has been making the case that this is a virus that has been downplaying at times, has been talking about the virus in a way saying that it's going to be in the rearview mirror. Just this week, he was making fun of Joe Biden for wearing a mask, but it underscores what the health officials have told us, which is that it's very important to wear masks. It's very important to social distance. And now we're seeing an outbreak literally in the headquarters of the United States. It's remarkable, William.
It is. And I think I've seen some people, some highly respected public health officials who I know personally and I've been talking with quite a bit, who argue that this is a real failure on the part of the White House and the people around him to protect the president. Because this is not just a man at a motorcycle rally in South Dakota who might be concerned about how he interacts. His health impacts all of us, and it impacts the reason we're talking about this, the reason this has impacts on the election and the courts and all of the functionings of our government is that we need the man we elect to be president to remain healthy.